You're watching Living Black, coming to you from Warmun in Western Australia. In March this year, this small town in the East Kimberley region was devastated by floods. The residents here were forced to evacuate and seek temporary shelter. But 6 months after the floods, much of the town has been rebuilt and the locals have moved into new homes. Jenny Curtis reports.
This is the remote Kimberley town of Warmun. Today it's a place alive with optimism. But back in March, tragedy struck as torrential rain caused the waters of Turkey Creek to rise dangerously high. The flooding engulfed the entire community. 85 homes were washed away and the local Gidja people had to be evacuated for 4 months during the clean-up operation. Now 6 months on, life is slowly returning to normal as the ruined homes are being rebuilt. Many have been demolished altogether. Still in the floodplain, they risk being damaged again in the future. Residents recall the horror of when the floods decimated the town.
And, you know, we were up crying, you know, really sad. We saw everything going, cars, and all sort of, you know, our home, like school, pensioner unit, disability, they were all covered with water and it was real hard for us.
The Western Australian government, with the help of federal government funding, has made sure the houses are being rebuilt. But for now, just a few lucky families get to be back in a home they can call their own.
Happy. We're like, we've never even left. Yeah, but the house is different, it's more bigger. I've got 5 kids and it's more roomy.
Like many others, Jolene lost most of her personal effects during the flood.
Terrible. We couldn't get anything out. Only when we came back, we had to just get a little bit stuff like beds and just tables, that's all. But nothing else, everything else was ruined.
The rebuilds are taking place on higher ground to avoid future flooding. It's costing $60 million to replace and repair the homes, but that doesn't even account for the community buildings, the cost of which is as yet unknown. Warmun's famous for its artwork, but the centre and much of its contents were badly damaged. Likewise, the school, which must also be rebuilt.
But it's still going to be a tough time ahead for many Warmun residents who are unable to move into their new homes immediately. The state government says it's working as fast as possible, but it's simply not able to build all the new homes overnight.
About 200 people have been housed in purpose-built temporary accommodation in Warmun at a cost of $15 million. Some families find the cramped living conditions hard to handle.
It's a bit hard. People want to go back to their own camp and have their own, live with their family in their own house and stuff, you know? Just being around your own privacy and your own family and sitting around the campfire with your kids and gangais and jojis and yarning and stuff like that. You know?
There were big celebrations in July when the residents moved back to Warmun. But WA's Deputy Premier Kim Hames, who flew up for the festivities, says he understands people's frustrations.
They're just dongers at the end of the day, and it's hard for families and children to live in accommodation like that, but they've coped very well, and they looked after very well their houses in the communities where they were, and we're sure they'll do the same here.
He felt it was much better for the Gidja people to be in Warmun, even if many of the residents have to endure the compact accommodation.
There's access to alcohol at Kununurra, where this is an alcohol-free community. Now, the concern we had is them being away from home, being places where they had access, but they wanted to come home to their own country as well. And even their paintings, they were saying they couldn't do them because they weren't in their own land. This is their own land, and they were desperate to get back to it, and it was in their own best interest for us to do everything we could to get them back quickly.
The rebuild's making good progress. The state government says new homes will be released over the coming months. It aims to have everyone back into their own house by March next year.